Hello everyone and welcome back to another Star Wars figure review. Today I'm going to be going over the MTT, Multi-Troop Transport. This is of course originated from the Phantom Menace. Little story, I kind of wish they would have made this back then because even though I didn't like episode 1 that much, I mean I thought there were some cool things in it, like this here. I thought it was excellent. Then when Hasbro decided to make their big vehicle, I was hoping and praying that they would make this thing. And then when I got the news that they did, or were going to make it, I just seriously screamed. I couldn't believe it. I just jumped for joy, basically. I couldn't believe it. So yes, here it is before you, and I can't wait to show you guys this. I did get it for a great price, which is $78.62 when Amazon had their little sale, but sadly it went back up. It's a little bit down slightly, but also if you're wanting to still get this thing, Walmart has the best price currently if they still have their sale, which is like $64.50, I believe. So 50% off that is not bad. Anyways, just to clarify, I'm gonna go over the three figures on the top first, then we'll get into the actual vehicle. So with that, let's get started. First up is Obi-Wan Kenobi, and for what I understand, he's not new whatsoever. It's simply because of this. I don't know if you can see it that well. Let me see if I can get the camera to focus. Well, if not, it says 1999, so yes, it could be just a remake. I didn't collect figures back then very much. Anyways, the detailing is poor, and then the articulation is just as bad by today's standards. He has a swivel neck, swivel shoulders, swivel cut elbows, which are very awful, a swivel waist, and barely swivel hips. Then you do have the lightsaber, which is not like molded onto his hand. The only cool feature I like about him is they actually use material for his braid to signify a Padawan. Let me see if I can actually zoom in on that. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Next, you get 20 battle droids, and only 4 of the ones with the backpack. And surprisingly, the ones with this are the most articulated. So yes, the standard battle droid. He has a ball-jointed neck, swivel shoulders, and ball-jointed hips, slightly. And that is all, nothing else. Then every other battle droid that doesn't have the backpack has a little slot in the back where you can plug in their blaster, which I'll show you here in a minute. But first, I want to show you guys something. This is the vintage collection battle droid compared to this one. As you can see, he has a lot of detailing, like weathering and such, and this one's just plain. They had to cut costs so the MTT won't be so pricey, so they did that both in texturing and articulation. Not only that, ladies and gentlemen, he is now putty. that's funny. Okay, now here's the other one. So yes, less articulated, only has a ball-jointed neck, and then only one swivel shoulder. The other one is just molded onto his leg. Now at the bottom, you have this little platform that you can stick onto the droid rack, which I'll show you later in the MTT. And yes, there's the slot for the blaster. Now let's move on to the vehicle, folks. On the front, you have 2 cannons, which they can only pivot. Plus, they're also made of a slightly cheap plastic. Up top, the hatch does open up to the cockpit. As you can see, I have the other 3 battle droids with backpacks in there. This MTT does come with stickers, but I didn't bother putting them on. Then, let me just go ahead and set this down. Just give me a moment, guys. In here are little guns that you can pull out. And they're actually supposed to go face like so. And up top, right there, is the button that you can press to make the missiles go out, which I'm not going to demonstrate because I don't really want to lose these things. Surprisingly, it's actually more detailed than you would think. Like, for example, these little holes right here are actually, they're not holes, but they're actually textured on. I mean, it's not just there, it's the entire vehicle. I'm surprised that they actually went that extra mile instead of just, like, painting them on. Then on each side, you have a ladder where you can put your battle droids, make it look like they're climbing into the cockpit up there. On each side of the vehicle, you have a little plate that comes down. They're both exactly the same, so I'll just show you this side. You just pull it down like so. Inside, it's actually quite detailed. Then the plate has enough peg holes for quite a bit of action figures. That little part there is for your battle droid blasters. And actually, up on the top, there is some more peg holes, including right there as well. On the bottom, you have a grand total of 6 wheels. They actually spin very well. 2 at the front and 4 at the back. And then, right there is the on and off switch, which I'll, right now it's off, but when we get to the electronics, I'll go ahead and turn it on. On the top here, where you have a couple of these peg holes for your figures, it's actually a storage area. Kind of hard to get it open, but you can actually fit some figures inside, surprisingly. And then I have most of the battle droid blasters in there, as you can see. In a little bit, I'll explain why, but still, pretty cool little feature. Now we get to the electronics. The center button here actually does a couple of sound effects. I probably won't get to them all, but okay, I know there are some droid phrases. I don't know if I'll be able to fit them into the video. Also, yes, you do have that feature as well. It'll play automatically sometimes, which the AT-AT did back then as well. Unfortunately, when I shot the review of my ad, I didn't know it was supposed to do that automatically, even after having it a couple weeks. Anyways, this button here actually deploys the droid rack, and the one at the end takes it back, you know, just pulls it back. I don't know what would happen if I hit the same button twice, and I'd rather not find out. So, let's go ahead and deploy them droids. Okay, guys, let's deploy the droids. That is the most awesome feature about this vehicle. And it is the purpose of the MTT, multi-troop transport. It's supposed to deploy droids. Now, the few things I want to point out are, number one, this little rack on each side that comes down, like so. It will adjust to any surface, so it doesn't have to be a flat surface. So that's one thing I want to tell you guys. The other is, the only reason why I don't have the battle droids blasters in their hands or the back is because some of them, they don't stay on very well or stay in. So if one of them accidentally came loose inside while it was coming out, there's a slight chance it could jam up the motors. It's a chance I don't want to take. I mean, it could not or could happen, so not going to risk it. The droids in the back there. Well, that don't matter. The other thing I want to point out is this hatch on the top. This oval piece is supposed to be up top, and this piece below is only supposed to be underneath. I don't know if it's a design to keep them coming out more smooth or not, but I'm a critic, so I thought I'd mention that. That's like a little mistake they made. I don't know if it is a mistake, so I'm just pointing that out. And the final thing I want to mention is the phrases in this vehicle are, I think they're, yeah, pretty much all of them are taken from the Clone Wars, except I think a few are made up. Just because in the scene where they were deployed, they didn't actually say nothing, so they had to substitute, which is not bad, I'll give them credit. Now, we get to reloading the droids. Now, follow these steps correctly, or else you could ruin your MTT. On both sides, you'll have these. Make sure they're pushed in both in the front and the back, on both sides. Make sure you hear them click. Then you push this down. It makes a sound, and also, again, make sure you hear the click. And before you get the droids back in, make sure these are in again. Because sometimes they actually come loose after you push this down. So make sure. Alright. Now we are ready to get these guys back home. Then we get to the very large packaging. Very nice box work. Let me go ahead and show you guys the back. Let me just set the camera down like so. Plus on corners and such, you do get different pieces of art. There's the bio if you want to pause the video and read it. Well guys, that's everything I had to show you for this big monstrous vehicle. What do you think? 5 out of 5? 4 out of 5? 3 out of 5? 2 out of 5? 1 out of 5? Or just complete 0? My true opinion, I'm going to have to go 4.5 out of 5. That's just me. Because of the few things I did point out, like the hatch thing, and then the battle droids not being made so well, that's just, like I said, because they're trying to save money. Plus, if they were the good ones, I mean, imagine $300 probably for this thing. Sheesh. Anyways, that's all the time I have for this vehicle review. Until next time, guys. Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.